מחכים לעודד שיצטרף עלינו, אבל כל הזמן הזה מחכה לנו ספוטלייט שדני מסניק שיכול לדבר איתנו על SourMint, the case of malicious advertisement SDK affecting thousands of mobile apps. דני, כבמה שלך.
תודה רבה, תודה רבה, רואים את הסלייד שלי? כן, אני מקווה שכן רואים את הסלייד. רק לוודא. אוקיי, סבבה, אני מקווה שרואים. Hello everyone, and thank you all for joining my talk. We will talk about SourMint, a research project we did at Snyk into a malicious SDK that we identified. So as I said, my name is Dani. I'm the co-founder and security research at Snyk, coming from a security background, also a CTF player with my awesome team, Pastan. You can find me on Twitter as Grunder. And I'm here just to share all the details about the research, but the good people that did the actual research are my good friends and colleagues, Kirill and Raul. So when we do research at Snyk, we typically do the analysis at scale. Basically, we look at all the open source, all the components on different package managers, and analyze them. And so what we did this time is looked at CocoaPods. Basically, we analyzed all the components there and look for things that are suspicious. Particularly, we looked at libraries that do what's called the method swizzling. Method swizzling is when you hook into system instruments, system functions, system API, and try to manipulate the data that it is being passed to them. So what we found is an interesting library called Mintegral Ad SDK. It's a popular library, an SDK that is advertised, that is promoted and shared by a company named Mintegral. It's a company that spun off of a public company named Movista. Both are headquartered in China. And so this is a company that basically helps developers monetize on their app through advertisement. The SDK is integrated into 3,500 apps and in both Google Play and iOS. And so I'm sure you are familiar with some of those apps. Some of them are very, very popular games and are other applications. And the interesting thing is that in total, monthly downloads of all the games and application that has the SDK exceeds 1 billion times. So more than 1 billion times, but 1 billion downloads a month. So pretty staggering number. So what did we found? First, we found a spying on network, on user activity and network activity. So basically, if you have an app that communicates with your backend and sends, for example, authorization tokens to your backend, these headers, these HTTP headers and the content will go to Mintegral, the malicious actor here. The other thing, and that's probably why they collected this whole data, is that they performed an attribution fraud through click hijacking. Basically, if you typically what happens when a user sees an advertisement and clicks on that advertisement, basically the attribution goes to that network, that advertisement network that presented the advertisement. What Mintegral did here is basically send a fake click saying that the advertisement came from their network and basically taking the money from other advertisers. The other crazy thing really that we found is an RCE, remote code execution backdoor. So this means that every app had a secret piece of code that allowed for remote code execution on the device in the context of that app that it was integrated to. So again, this is I'm talking about this very quickly. You can later read through all the write-ups, and of course on the Discord channel we can discuss it. I also share the full video of the kind of attacks that are that can be happen there. But this is just an example of stealing the clipboard, which contains a password that it was copied from one password, sorry, last pass, and this is being sent to their servers. Another thing we found is download tracking. So basically, downloads of other apps or Google Docs or Google Spreadsheets, anything that is downloaded from Google on an Android device, being tracked and sent back to Mintegral. So again, I'll share all the data on the Discord channel. So the crazy thing is that they tried to hide this. So, you know, this looks like a full-blown malicious component, they would try to identify whether you're trying to debug the app. And basically, if they see that you're trying to debug, they will turn off all the malicious functionality. If the device is jailbroken, if there is a proxy, interception proxy enabled, they will not enable the malicious functionality. So we went public with all our findings in August this year. And you know, immediately the malicious code was removed, and the attribution fraud also stopped. Actually, some interesting data coming from Singular, where they show that before our publication, there was this, you know, high rate of fake double clicks being sent to the to MMPs, and then, you know, after our publication, this whole thing kind of was reduced significantly. Mopub, Twitter is a mediation platform, and Iron Source removed the thing from their mediation platforms. And so in summary, you know, we had just one SDK. This was integrated into several thousands of apps, but it got eventually distributed to billions of users. So that's, you know, pretty amazing impact for just single SDK. And that kind of shows the story of, you know, of developers bringing components that are not aware of, you know, what they're doing, but also kind of, you know, eventually distributing into the billions of users. So I'll share all the details on the Discord channel, but this is kind of all the links to the blog post and the research write-ups. And this is it. And I hope that you enjoyed this quick 5-minute talk. Thank you very much, and Chag Sameach.
Thank you very much, Danny. It was super nice. Thank you for disclosing all this information and making all the publishers and other companies make work more efficient. Have a good day.